Welcome to Discovering. 5 days into the trapping season, 13 coyotes, 10 fox, and a coon, and she is just getting started.
She always managed to check my traps before I did. So I said, hey, if you're gonna check traps, we'll set your own, and by golly, that's what she did.
He was trapping first, and he'd take me with him. I don't know, I just kind of took it over for him. I'm not sure if he's happy with that, but.
That's all tonight, so sit back, put your feet up. It's Monday night and time for Discovering.
The secret streams that flow beneath the cliffs of colored stone. Forest thick and healthy with birch and pine and oak. Surrounded by the greatest lakes this world has ever known. The black bear's awesome presence as he roams the hills and fields. Call of the timber wolf, the loon's lonesome trill. The eagle soaring high above, the trout lies deep and still. These are what I treasure, the only way I measure feelings that I have for this fine land. There is so much to discover when your longtime lover of northern Michigan.
I started trapping when my grandfather, when I was in the sixth grade. I bought all my own school clothes since I was in the sixth grade. $20 for bounty was a lot of money back then. You could buy a wardrobe for a week. And as we got a little bit older, we started getting out on our own. My dad was a water trapper, mink, muskrats, beaver, otter. My grandfather was a predator trapper, coyotes and the fox and the bobcats, coons. So I had the best of both worlds. I had a mentor on both sides of my family.
The Upper Peninsula is indeed a special place, a place where we live like we want to live.
I love being out in the wild for one thing, and I love to hunt.
A place where the people are friendly and the game is wild. A place where men like to hunt, fish, and trap. And so do the women.
And when I met my wife and we got married, she started trapping with me and hung out with me, got interested in it. She likes to hunt fish, and now she likes to trap.
Oh, right here. He's right here.
We have a lot of fun together trapping, but she used to follow me around, and she knew where all my traps were.
Wow.
I don't know how she got ahead of me, but she always managed to check my traps before I did. So I said, hey, if you're gonna check traps, we'll set your own, and by golly, that's what she did. She went and set her own, and we both go our separate ways now. Once in a while, we get to go together, which is fun, but we usually on our own. She's by herself by four-wheeler, I go by truck. I can get on the river and set some mink traps too.
With these drags, I like to take them and put them in the ground this way, stake them in.
We really look forward to this time of the year. It's a lot of work, a lot of prep, all summer prep working, dyeing traps, hand tuning traps, figuring out where you want to go. It ends up being a lot of fun this time of the year.
I've always caught fox in here. This is one of my favorite cubby holes in here. I like this area because you can't see it from anywhere on the road. Yeah, he had this whole thing all tore up. Just a simple little station set there. So they got, like I said, they got a game trail right here. You know, and they like to come around these roads. That's all they do.
Hardly any more small game left. All we got in the woods is predators. So we decided to shift from small game to predators. There seems to be more of them than anything. So we have a lot of fun doing that. And that's what we're all about in the fall of the year.
All right, let's get this bad boy back in the ground.
Try to help out some of these sportsmen that can go out and shoot a partridge and a rabbit and keep the numbers of predators down. That's our goal.
Make sure that nothing gets underneath that pan. And this, it's like a stepping stone right there. And we're good to go.
Good, good.
Takes a lot of time when you find stuff like that, like the trap's been dug up, or takes a little time to sit here and fix it back up and put it back the way it was. Got some smart ones out there, though. They seem to know where the traps are at half the time. They'll dig them right up and leave them right out in the open for you. So they're smart. When I first started setting traps with Babe, he's helping me put all these traps out, and I'm going, how am I supposed to remember where every single trap is at? But now I got a routine. So I got my own little trails I go down, and some days you'd be lucky if you catch one or two. I had something messy with that the last time I was here too. This is where I caught one of the fox. Oh yeah, it looks pretty good. That fox had this all tore up. He had everything tore up. No. These right here, you gotta be careful. I've walked up on skunks here before. I also have a live trap here, trying to get rid of skunks. Something's been walking here. Nothing. Nope, nothing. Came here one day, and I walked up. I didn't see anything in the trap, but I could see that it was all messed up. And I walked up to the hole, and I looked in, and the skunk's looking right at me. Good to go. Things start slowing down after about the third day, so this is another hiding spot here. Right in that hole, right there. And it looks as natural as possible, so. They'll get nosy. Oh, ho, ho, I got a coyote. Got a coyote. All right, it started out as just a little hole, probably about this big. And this is what you get. They dig everything up. So I've got 67 traps out. And I can actually tell you where every single one of them are at right now. So when he was trapping, I'd go out with him and watch him. And then, you know, I started spending a lot of time out in the woods. And you notice that there's a lot of predator out there. Not enough prey. I think this way, okay, we can help cut down on some of the predators and get some birds and rabbits back in the woods again. Used to be over here, now it's gonna go over this way. You only wear one set of gloves for doing this. Same set of gloves. And you make sure these are all put with everything that you use for your trapping. I use my knees and I cheat. Always keep your finger behind. That I learned my lesson the hard way. Make sure your pan, and then it's just let it up. And she's, make sure you want to keep your pan flat. Try to keep it as flat as possible. It's got to be solid on the ground. It can't shift. Them coyotes are smart. They know. I like using leaves because they're more natural. You want to keep anything from going underneath the pan, because if, naturally, if it goes under the pan, it's not going to set off. I'm more fussy than he is, so clean everything up here. Now it's all set, it's just, you just leave it and it'll work. After the first few days, it kind of slows down. Usually when it slows down a lot, I'll move some of my traps to a different area.
Yeah, they know it's there once they find it. But now see all these tracks right here. If you were to move that trap back, you try for a hind foot catch, because he's going to run in there and start digging again. So you move this trap back here about a foot off to one of the sides. But that's a perfect coyote trap, a number two Bridger, four coil laminated offset. It doesn't get any better than that Cadillac. I was coming by snooping in the summertime, always looking for sign. And I'm come by here one day and I see sand, and I thought, what the heck is that? So I got investigating, and there's a coyote den in there. If you gotta look real close to see it, that den's been there for a couple, two or three years that I know of. Yeah, that's a well hidden coyote den.
Usually when I go to set up for a trap, I always check out the area that I'm in. You want to get into where there's like game trails, because the animals like to walk on that. And when they come out here, this is where they come through all the time to walk. So you have to watch for like game trails and you know, the roads. They like the crossroads and that. Everything is all about location. You got to make sure that you've got location, location, location. That's it. That's the main thing for trapping, is the location you put it in. So, but if you can do that, you can catch one. Well, if you keep them hidden and people don't bother them, you know, and they stay out of the way, you know, and like I said, the animals that, it has to do with location, always location. And to set it up there, it's by a crossroad, it's, you know, it's hidden out of sight, and that's what they like to do. They like to sneak around and snoop. That's what they are. They're snoopy animals. So they check everything out. On this trap here, I've got the bait up here and my traps here, and anything that comes in is usually got a step here to stick their nose in that hole. But sometimes you get a smart one that comes in and he circles around to the side, so then you gotta learn how to trick him too. So but yeah, this here is it. This is pretty much one of my favorites, I think. I like it because, like I said, they're really nosy. They gotta stick their nose into everything, so, and in order to do that, they'd have to step up here to get their nose in that hole. So, and I always get tips from Babe. He helps me out. He's the one that taught me all this anyway. I enjoy it. Gives me a chance to be out in the outdoors. Well, the reason for the leaves is to keep that sand from coming underneath the pad. So that, because anytime they step on it, if there's anything underneath that pad's not going down, it's, the trap won't set off. The leaves are, they're more natural out in the woods, you know. The animals are around them all the time, so it's not a new scent for them to catch. So this is something they're always around. I was out here when it was raining. That is hard, setting traps in the rain, because everything is nothing but mud. Usually we have some calcium chloride, and you can mix it in there, and it keeps the dirt from freezing up. This is an all-day thing right here. Especially when you've got all the traps that I've got out. So, especially when you've got to stop and you reset every one of them. And, you know, like I said, some are dug up, some are flipped over, some are set off. So, it's a job. It's a workout. You have to make sure that you're aware of the area around you. You want to make sure that you stay safe at all times when you're out in the woods, especially when you're by yourself. Anything can happen. Most of the time I keep a pistol on me, but today I don't have one with me. It's in my bike. So that's because I got two big guys with me today. Looks pretty well set in there. Little smarty pants. I should set a trap right there. Put one in, outsmart him. He decided to make his own little trail over here. It's like a more or less a safety trail. At least he thinks it's safe. So next time he comes in to do a little checking, he's going to find out that It's not as safe as he thinks it is. And thinks he's safe walking up here. He's gonna find out that he's got a surprise coming. Yeah, smart little bugger. Let's see if I can outsmart him. Just leave everything the way it is. And clean up my mess. Make it look like he was the only one here. It takes pretty much all day, especially with 67 traps out there. And like I said, my husband has to call me and ask me if I'm coming home for the night. So he has to remind me I've got home somewhere. Unfortunately, there's some times where I just don't have the time to check every single trap. And, you know, I hate doing that. I would rather come back that night, if I had to, with a flashlight. And oh, I come close on this one. That'll get his attention. Well, that's a pretty spot out here. Look at the coyote tracks. They just missed my trap. I walked around a corner here one day and there was a skunk standing right here. Yeah, wow. That's a, this is a big boy here. Holy cow. Oh my God, this one's heavy. Okay, where am I gonna put this little fella? Throw him on your bike or whatever kind of lure you put in the hole. You have to make sure that you're not touching your traps because the coyotes smell that. They'll dig your traps right up. So they'll dig them right up on you. So you have to make sure that you only use one pair of gloves to handle your traps. Yeah, I think it's the fourth day today. The other day I had seven fox. And then the day after that I had 3 coyotes and 2 fox. And then today I've got 3 coyotes and a fox and a coon now. So I think I'm doing pretty good. I hope that I got one more spot out by US-2 that I have left, and my day's done. And then I get to go home.